penyiasatan adalah di bawah dua section. Kononnya di bawah section 27.5 Akta Polis, iaitu mengenai perhimpunan haram kononnya lah ya. Dan yang kedua di bawah section 41 Akta Hasutan. Okey. Dan beberapa soalan telah ditanya pegawai yang merekodkan kenyataan dalam kes YB Azmin adalah Dr. Wasu, ASP Dr. Wasu Apu. And the others, I think you let them know. Soalan-soalan ini dan penyiasatan ini adalah timbul daripada ceramah yang di yang dikendalikan di pejabat Khidmat Gombak pada malam 25 Mac hari Jumaat. Now, saya hendak menyatakan dari awalnya ya, sebenarnya ceramah ini dijalankan secara sah dan menurut undang-undang, tetapi ia diceroboh secara salah dan menyalahi undang-undang oleh pihak polis. Jadi sepatutnya dari awal pihak polis yang perlu disiasat dalam kes ini dan bukan wakil-wakil rakyat ini. Okay, having said that, saya juga kagum, I'm shocked and surprised to see the kind of questions that were asked during the statement giving. It is the kind of questions that seems to suggest that we are living in a police state or a dictatorship. Among the questions that were asked, adakah ceramah tersebut membangkitkan perasaan rakyat untuk menentang kerajaan? Okay, this is the most ridiculous question. It suggests that we are in a police state and that you cannot ask the rakyat to that you cannot criticize the government in this country. Adakah Egypt dan Tunisia telah ditimbulkan di dalam ceramah tersebut? Can you imagine the kind of questions that are being asked in this in what is clearly an attempt to turn this country into a police state if it is not already a police state? And also questions like adakah anak muda, adakah anak muda diminta untuk cetuskan perubahan di negara ini? Another example, I've given you three examples. So we have to say this quite clearly. The questioning today was nothing but harassment, intimidation of the wakil rakyat who were carrying out their duties. Okay, the questioning was simply in order to prevent the opposition from questioning government policies, from explaining their policies to the rakyat through political ceramah.
Yang memeranjatkan saya, pegawai yang merakamkan percakapan saya sebentar tadi sendiri belum lagi melihat dan membaca laporan polis yang dibuat terhadap saya. Rakaman ini dibuat berdasarkan soalan-soalan yang telah disiapkan oleh IPK ya, Selangor. Sebanyak 18 soalan dikemukakan kepada saya dan soalan-soalan itu menjurus kepada perkara-perkara yang jelas menunjukkan bahawa negara ini adalah negara polis dan diperintah oleh seorang diktator. Dan telah diterangkan tadi beberapa contoh soalan yang dikemukakan kepada saya. Saya mengambil kesempatan ini untuk bertanya kepada pegawai-pegawai polis sebentar tadi, mengapa tidak ada laporan polis dibuat terhadap Muhyiddin Yassin yang mengadakan perhimpunan politik terbuka di Kampung Pandan malam tadi, di bawah pentadbiran polis yang sama, di bawah IPD yang sama. Sedangkan program saya merupakan program yang aman yang dijalankan di Pusat Khidmat Rakyat Parlimen Gombak, iaitu pejabat saya sendiri dalam kompaun saya sendiri dan bukannya satu tempat terbuka seperti yang dianjurkan oleh Muhyiddin malam tadi. Tetapi soalan ini tidak dapat dijawab oleh pegawai-pegawai polis yang berkenaan. Maka saya telah mengarahkan peguam-peguam saya untuk mengemukakan notis kepada pihak polis dan tempoh 48 jam telah pun tamat dan kita akan memulakan prosiding tindakan undang-undang terhadap pegawai-pegawai polis yang bertanggungjawab merusuh dan mengganggu program aman kami pada 25 Mac yang lalu.
The legal action is because there were several offences that were committed by the police which give rise to civil liability on the part of the police, such as trespass, the disruption of the ceramah. There was assault because my client was pushed down actually during the event. There were also several unlawful arrests that were carried out by the police at the when they disrupted the ceramah So all this gives rise to civil liability. They are liable in damages. But we have asked them, it's not our intention to make money or ask for damages. As a matter of principle, we said apologize, undertake not to repeat this kind of behavior again. That's what we said, because we want to make sure that the police act according to the law. That was our intention in saying that we will take legal action unless they apologize and give an undertaking. So far we have heard nothing from them. So we may have no choice. We take them to court. It is to ensure that the police act according to the law and do not oppress the rakyat. That is our motive in taking this matter to court.
Tangkap Rahim.